On this week's edition of Wildcat Weekly, the Wildcat Cafe and a pumpkin painting contest. All this and more coming up next. Trick or treat! Welcome to this week's spooky edition of Wildcat Weekly. I'm your host, Gianna Potasek. The Wildcat Cafe is a great opportunity to get coffee or hot chocolate in the morning. David has the story.
The Wildcat Cafe gives students and faculty members the opportunity to get coffee and hot chocolate. Located next to the vending machines in the lunchroom, the great thing about the Wildcat Cafe is that it is operated by our very own Neuqua Valley students.
Wildcat Cafe is a program that is run by the students in the AIM program. It's a coffee shop to promote independence and work on different vocational and life skills. It technically started about 3 years ago. We did have to miss a year because of COVID, but even at that time over Zoom, the students practiced listening to orders and picking out the correct item.
So this idea of the Wildcat Cafe was created because we wanted more opportunities for our students to practice real life skills, real life vocational skills that might help them in the future. And also in addition to that, to promote inclusion throughout Neuqua.
The Wildcats who work at the Wildcat Cafe enjoy their job and love the variety of drinks that are served there.
Tea, hot chocolate, and coffee.
Chocolate. Making hot chocolate.
Make sure to stop by the Wildcat Cafe first or seventh period on Thursdays and Fridays. And for Wildcat Weekly, I'm David Bridges.
Trick or treat! Interested in improving your culinary skills or just looking for a tasty treat? Senior Foods is the perfect class for upcoming upperclassmen. Kendall has the details.
Senior Foods is a facts class dedicated to only senior students, where they are able to learn and participate in cooking and handling food. The students gain hands-on experience with following recipes to create a variety of different meals.
People in the class, some of them have taken foods classes before and some of them have not. It's open to any senior who is wanting to take a culinary class before they graduate. It is one of the most popular electives for seniors at Neuqua. A typical week in Senior Foods, we cook 2 to 3 times a week, and then the other days we are preparing for the lab that we're going to do. So that can be just kind of like talking about the lab, talking about the different like cooking procedures that are going to take place during the lab. And then when we're in the other room, that's not the kitchen, we do a lot of prep work, so you know, cutting up the vegetables that we may be using, preparing any batters that we're going to be making. That way when we come into the kitchen, we are ready to go and ready to finish and eat the lab.
Not only do the seniors in this class learn about cooking, but they also learn a plethora of discipline, time management, and responsibility skills while still enjoying the class.
Some of the things I like about foods is just being able to work with others, like collaborating with others, just sharing ideas, especially in the kitchen, and also be able to, you know, learn a big skill such as cooking. I think it's like really fun and overall just a really good class.
Make sure to keep Senior Foods in mind when picking classes for your own senior year. And for Wildcat Weekly, I'm Kendall O'Keefe.
Trick or treat! Pumpkin spice is an iconic fall flavor. Brooke puts Dunkin' and Starbucks to the test to determine the best flavor.
With fall in full swing, many restaurants have introduced their fall menus. 4 Neuqua students are here to determine their favorite.
Okay, so first we're going to try the pumpkin spice latte from Starbucks. So the first thing I noticed was that this one has whipped cream on top and then like cinnamon powder. And it's also the more expensive option. So let's try it.
I like it. I like it too.
Oh, that's actually good. I can like taste like the coffee in it, but it's like
a little sweet.
I like it. Yeah, it's still sweet.
I give it a 7.5 out of 10.
I give it an 8.
I give it a 10.
I give it a 9. Okay, so now we're trying the Dunkin' pumpkin spice lattes, and they're a lot bigger than the Starbucks drinks, and there's also no whipped cream. So let's try.
This one's more bitter than the Starbucks
one.
Yeah. I don't really taste pumpkin.
Yeah, it's more coffee.
It's a lot of coffee. I taste more like pumpkin, like the spice part of the pumpkin.
Yeah.
I don't know. I rate it a 8 out of 10.
I rate it like a 6.5.
I rate it like a 5.
think like 7 out of 10. Okay, so in conclusion, we've decided that out of the two, that Starbucks has the better pumpkin spice latte this fall.
You heard it here first. Starbucks comes out on top with their pumpkin spice latte. And for Wildcat Weekly, I'm Brooke Harrison.
Trick or treat! With Halloween coming up this Saturday, we asked many NEQA students what they plan on wearing this Halloween. Matt has the details.
With Halloween coming this Sunday, we asked the NEQA Valley students what costumes they were wearing.
Yo, I'm planning up to dress as Sora from the Kingdom Hearts series.
Justin Herbert.
This year, I'm going to be the triangle guy from Squid Game.
My name is Eric Perea, and I'm going to be Ice JJ Fish.
I'll probably dress up as my mom.
Your grandma.
Butterflies!
All right, so for this Halloween, I'm going to be NBA Youngboy.
So I'm going to be Ketchup.
And I'm going to be Mustard.
I'm going to be a crewmate.
I'm going to be the imposter.
I'm going to be one of the Sanderson sisters from the movie Hocus Pocus, so I'll be the redhead.
My plan is to watch The Croods 2 on Netflix with two other guys on a couch.
I'm probably just going to go as myself. I think I'm pretty scary enough.
All right, we're going to be Rick and Morty. I'm going to be Rick.
I'm going to be Morty.
The soldier from Squid Game, yeah.
I'm going to be a devil this year.
Probably a snowman.
Mario.
John Keller from the English department.
I'm going to be for Tom Brady for Halloween.
With many of the students dressing up for Halloween, for Wildcat Weekly, I'm Matt Riley.
Pumpkin painting is a fun way to be creative this Halloween. Cameron puts the Wildcat Weekly coordinating producers to the test to see which pumpkins paint the best.
The CPs were given a challenge to paint a Halloween-themed pumpkin in under 25 minutes, only using paint and paintbrushes. Let the challenge begin.
So far, I've been the first one to finish, and this is what I have so far. And since I finished so fast, I've started on another side, and everyone else is still going. So I feel really good right now, and I think I'm gonna win. So
everyone else is kind of done with their pumpkin, and I'm still working. So, like, you know what they say, you work a long time and you'll have success. So I'm just ready for this win.
I think I'm just outclassing them with the paintbrush. Not all of them know how to work it, like a modern-day Bob Ross like myself. I was inspired from the photos I saw online of easy pumpkin ideas, and I think he came out pretty beautiful compared to the photo. I think I kind of took it and ran with it, made it my own, and you see, it's just absolutely phenomenal.
So I decided to play it safe, so, and I think that's probably a good thing, because some of us tried to do some things that are a little bit more detailed, like Charlie, and I think that'll help me win, so.
After tallying your guys' votes on our Instagram poll, Gianna, representing Group D, collected the most votes. Congratulations. Yeah! And for Wildcat Weekly, I'm Cameron Singer.
Thank you for watching this week's spooky edition of Wildcat Weekly.
Happy Halloween, Wildcats!